down the hammer and pick up the pencil. You're about to listen to the Savvy Radio Show. Learn from real-life real estate investors, experience revealed with the Savvy Landlord as your host.
You tuned back in. I didn't know 33 minutes of the last episode would wear you out. And we're still on the entrepreneur kick. You just tuned in to the Savvy What? Radio Show. My name is Steve VanCauwenbergh. I am an entrepreneur, confessing. I am the Savvy Landlord, who is an entrepreneur, who wrote a book. And that's it. We're on 465 things to consider before you become an entrepreneur. Yes, you got to think of things before you just pull the trigger. First of all, are you pissed off? That's what you need to do. You need to take a stand. You need to go just do it. Bam. You got to get up in it. You got to just take a leap of faith. Now, there are just tons of books called Startup or Blank or The Circle, Profit Circle. There's tons of entrepreneur books. You should just go madly in love, get madly in love in entrepreneurism, starting a business. Try to hang out with another entrepreneur. But what you need to do, number one, is go do it. Take a stand. Say, I'm going to do it. If you got a family, understand, get 3 months, 6 months of savings and just pull the trigger. Even if you're an anal detail person, accountant, CPA, start a flipping firm. If you like to be on the beach, start a rental company. Whatever it is, I'm telling you today, things to consider, you need to just do it. Be an entrepreneur. If anything, do it on the side hustle. Just do it at night. I know this cat right now, he works with horses. Horses, who works with, I guess we're in Oklahoma, you know, we gotta work with horses. He's a detail guy, likes accounting, and does books for some horse people and makes some cheddar on the side. I'm trying to encourage that dude. Yo, you need to do this on a big scale. Why can't, how much do you need to make a month? Well, my dream is to, you know, retire my wife. Well, how much does your wife make? 70? Well, then there you go. Make 100. Set a goal and just go do it. Number two, all right, find the right business for you. What's the right business for you? Identify the right business for you. Like I'm telling you, you can do well. If you didn't know me by now, but I'm into the RC car deal. Now, I don't know how big I'm going to get it. I'm getting stung on some stuff, but I'm into the RC car deal. And I've been going to the racetrack. I've befriended a couple of these dudes, just fascinated about just the whole concept. Anyway, this dude has a racetrack and he's a super not outgoing guy. And he owns this racetrack. And he makes a living owning his own business. Why can't you do that? Why can't you? And he found out that his building leases up and he's looking for a building. And I was like, oh, opportunity. I was like, yo, let me help you find a building. Maybe we can work something out. I go, well, what's your budget? What are you paying for a lease now? He's like $3,000. I'm like, wow. In my mind, I just started thinking. But if you listen to the last episode, you start thinking, how do businesses work? How does he gain? What does he sell? Cars, what's the markup on the cars? Is it repairs? How does this work? If you can afford $3,000 a month for a commercial property plus utilities, hey, he's got to pull in some revenue, which is money. Is the business is right for you? Obviously, it's right for him. He has enough savings that he can build the track every other month or whatever. I don't know the mechanics of his business, but whatever it is, it's working for him. Find the right business that works for you, okay? What are you passionate about? What can you do for free? And how can you turn that into income? This is what I'm learning right now. Right now, I just feel like this season of my life is entrepreneurism 101, 202, 303, 404, 505, master's course. Okay. I'm about to go to Harvard in my mind. I want to be the very best. I want to be Richard Branson. I ain't going to lie to you. I want to get as many businesses as I can. I want to scale as fast as I can. I want to work with as many people as I can. Raise as much money as I can, but it all boils down to a business plan. Number three, you got to have a business plan. It definitely improves your chances of success. The big thing is, 98% of businesses fail or 90, all this negativity. I started ghetto businesses from a DJ business to a wedding business. They sustained. Right now, I wasn't drawing down a check. Watch Shark Tank for a while. The number one question they ask is, how did you come up with the evaluation? I get it. And number two, what are you paying yourself? Can you start this hustle and not have to go get the new Louis Vuitton, or you don't have to go get the newest iPad or phone, that you can deal with the old school? And is it making you money? If you have a business plan, you can scale. You can write down your goals, strategy, marketing plan. I started all my businesses with a napkin, and now I'm like, man, I'm fine tuning this process. How can I scale this business? How can I resell this business? I can't resell the business if I don't have a plan in place. Okay. Number four, pretty obvious. You got to have a target market. Who are you going after? This RC car world, dude's going after RC car people. Social media business, dude's going after people that own businesses, B2B. That's how the businesses I like to roll. I'm not a big fan of I own a business and I'm selling a service to a customer, because customers in my mind are fickle. I'm into B2B. If I help this business owner succeed, may it be coaching, social media, whatever I can do to increase their business, they're going to be gladly to pay me for their services rendered. That's the business I'm in. I'm into services. I'm into helping business owners succeed. That's who my target market is. If it's the RC car, is it a specific age group? When I was in the bridal business, I was helping young gals get married using other people's services. I had two target markets. I had one, I was marketing towards brides. I had to figure out what millennials wanted. You know, how can I engage them and have them get come to the venue? And then I had to help baby boomers, market to them, say, hey, you need to be in my bridal show to be successful. If you want to make more money, hey, be in the OK Bride bridal show and you will succeed. La da 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 da. Know, okay? Know your target audience. Who are you trying to sell to? All right, number five, money. Personal business finance, okay? You can't be controlled by money. What kind of money do you need to start the business? And if you're going to quit your job, how can you sustain? How long? What's your risk tolerance? How's it going to affect your babies? What is it going to do? Can you manage your own money? And are you going to be able to manage the business money? Are you able to keep it separate? One is one, one's the other. Don't co-mingle. You got to get your personal finances on lock. You got to understand what you're doing with the personal finances. Okay, that's another thing you need to think about. Number five. Number six, you got to have a support network. You got to have a team around you rallying you. Who can you lean on? Who's in that entrepreneur that you know, business owner? Maybe not in that specific. Join the chamber. Join a group. Start your own breakfast group. Get five guys together, five gals together, and work together. Work on a plan. Have a network. Leverage your network. Have a support group. You got to do it. Number seven. All right. You got to get ballistic on this. Number seven, you got to create value in people's life. Okay. Value. You can't sell services if that doesn't help people, or a product. If it doesn't help, you got to have value. Money needs to exchange hands. And how does it exchange? People have to get value. They get something for what they give. That's called value. What's the product or service that you're offering that's going to create value in their life? And if you can create value in their life, you'll be successful. And number eight, the final, you got to be a marketing wizard. You got to promote. You got to read books about sales and marketing. You can't be soft. You can't be shy. You got to make it happen. You got to grind it out. You got to promote this bad boy. Get the word out. I'm talking about every day. I love the people. And there's some psycho people right now. You know who they are? They got embroidered shirts. It says their name on there. They're getting the word out. They got business cards with their face on it. They got their car wrapped. They got a sticker. They're not ashamed of what they're doing. You got to put the hat on. You got to do it. You got to do it big. You got to promote. You got to get the word out there. Is that you? Are you ready to be an entrepreneur? Things to consider before you pull the trigger. Thanks for listening to the Savvy Radio Show, number 465. Man, we're going to do something at 500. Much love.
Thanks for listening to the Savvy Radio Show. Glide online and listen to our other motivating episodes at SavvyRadioShow.com. Connect on Twitter @LandlordBook and always be buying assets.